here in Albert Park. Welcome to Melbourne. And the roar from the crowd can only mean one thing. It's race day. Here we are then at the Albert Park Circuit, 3.28 miles of bumpy city streets, but not a lot in the way of elevation changes. The circuit goes all the way around the lake, taking in 14 corners. Note the DRS zones into turns 1, 3 and 13. They'll offer our drivers a number of good opportunities to overtake. It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. Robert Schwartzman lines up on pole position. And a very happy Carlos Sainz will start second. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Moore, Oscar Piastri, Sergio Perez, and Leclerc, Vettel, Zhou, Bottas, and Pierre Gasly, Tsunoda, Verstappen, they've taken a grid penalty, Mick Schumacher, and Tictum, Ocon, Albon, George Russell, and Lando Norris, Stroll, and Nicholas Latifi. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head down trackside for today's race. Natalie Pinkham joins me once again in the commentary box. It's fantastic to have you with us today. I'm curious though, how do you think the drivers stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, I imagine they'll be starting to feel the adrenaline as they anticipate the rundown into turn one, a bit like preparing to go into battle. The unknown situation will bring nerves, but that's a good thing. It'll keep them focused on the moment and on their surroundings as we build towards the start of the Grand Prix.
After the points finished last race, let's aim to keep that momentum going. Okay, how was that pull away? You'll have a bit more grip than that on the start, but we need to warm the tyres properly now. Make sure you get some heat into the brakes as well. Superb parking there, mate. Let's make sure we get the edge on the surrounding drivers as the lights go out. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid is formed. Be ready with the clutch. Fantastic. That is a brilliant, brilliant result. Well done.
Another superb Australian Grand Prix comes to an end then, and it's a thoroughly deserved victory. So, Natalie, what do you think helped them deliver this result?
Well, this was a real team victory. They put together a solid strategy today that appeared well suited to the conditions out on track. The driver did everything that was expected of them in the moment to really execute the team's plan to perfection. A shining example of how F1 really is a team sport.
Here come today's winning drivers, and what a race this was. This is a team that knows success very well in F1, and they're just itching for even more. Congratulations to the Alpine team for their excellent win today. Let's focus on the driver of the day. Natalie Pinkham, come on, who do you pick?
I think for driver of the day, I'd probably pick Lando Norris. He lived up to every inch of his reputation today, and I think he'll be going home, quite rightly, a bit proud of himself.
Let's move on to the constructors. Alpine's lead continues to grow at the head of the table. Meanwhile, Ferrari have improved their position. A strong weekend for them as they fight their way towards the top. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time out? Be sure to join us once again as we continue to bring you all the excitement of Formula One.